In this video, I'm going to show you how to install attic foil brand radiant barrier directly over your attic insulation, primarily for mixed or cold climates. Now, this is a follow-up video to an earlier video I did explaining why you should install a radiant barrier. That video covers the mechanics and exactly how a radiant barrier works. If you didn't see that video, you can click on the link below and you can watch it first. But the over the attic insulation method is primarily for cold or mixed climates. If you're in a hot climate, you've got a couple options. You can lay it directly over the attic insulation like this, or you can do the staple up method depending on your primary objective. But this video, I'm going to talk about the over insulation method, and I'm going to cover the two most common questions we get. One, what happens to dust settling on the top of the foil, how that affects the radiant barrier, and secondly, concerns about moisture traveling through the insulation and potentially getting trapped under the attic foil. Before you get started, there's a few tools you're going to need to make the job go fast and pretty easy. First thing you're going to need is a standard utility knife, pretty much the standard box cutter type knife with the throwaway blades. Don't use scissors, a box cutter is the way to go. Secondly, measuring tape. You might have to measure some pieces of foil, so you want to have this. A roll of foil air conditioning tape. This is available in any hardware store in the air conditioning ductwork department. Do not use duct tape, you want the foil tape. It's made to be in an attic and it sticks well to the foil. Also, a good quality dust mask, or this is what's called a half-face respirator. This is about 20 bucks and it includes what's called a P100 filter. This is especially important if you're around fiberglass insulation. The last thing you want to be doing is kicking up that fiberglass insulation and breathing it. That's money well spent. Also, a couple of clamp lights. These are handy. You can clamp them, move them around so you can see what you're doing. You always want to have good lighting when working in the attic. Finally, you're going to need to make a little tool. Basically, this is a piece of wood trim. You can use a broom handle, a PVC pipe, pretty much anything. And you're going to take a nail and just tape it to the end. This creates what's called a poker. And what you're going to be able to do is once you get that foil out, you can just stab the foil, the attic foil, and then you can push it back into the corners. That way you don't have to crawl across your attic. This is kind of like having an 8 or a 10 foot arm. Now, I'd recommend making a couple, maybe 1 4 or 5 feet, and maybe 1 8 or 10 feet, depending on how far you've got to reach back into the corners of your attic. Installing attic foil radiant barrier directly over your attic insulation is really pretty simple. People tend to overthink it and make it more complicated than it really is, but it's really not that complicated. So this video is going to be more kind of a checklist, basically what to do and a couple things not to do. And the big picture, really, there's two big rules you want to follow before we get started. The first thing is cover as much area as possible. Radiant barrier has a cumulative effect. Just like any of the videos, the more coverage, the better. Don't worry about little gaps or cracks, but you just want to cover as much area as possible. And the second thing, when you're installing the over-insulation method, is not to overlap the attic foil more than a couple of inches. Now, attic foil is perforated, so it'll allow moisture in its vapor form to pass through. But if you double it up, the chances are that moisture can't escape both layers because of the permeability. So when you overlap it, just an inch or two is really the most you want to do. You shouldn't have any problems. The first thing is you're just going to lay the attic foil directly on top of the attic insulation. There's no need to staple it down to the ceiling joist. You want that insulation above the ceiling joist. We don't want to compress it. Basically, it's just going to lay on top of the attic insulation, almost like a big blanket. If you want to staple it to a rafter in a corner, or if you've got an upright support and you want to staple it there, that's fine, but there's no need to staple it down. The next thing to understand is attic foil radiant barrier is not a substitute for regular attic insulation. You should have a good amount of attic insulation in your attic. If you can look down and see the ceiling joist, you need more attic insulation. Ideally, you're going to be at least a few inches above the wood. You should be able to look down and see no wood. If you don't have that much attic insulation, I'd recommend either going to Home Depot or Lowe's. They'll actually give you the machine. You can blow it in for free if you buy their attic insulation, or you can hire a company to come top it off. Now, if you do that, what you may want to do is leave a few little strips or paths that you can walk through later so you can install the attic foil. Then you can come back, and as you install the attic foil on top of the attic insulation, use something like a dustpan or something to shovel that insulation back to cover your paths. Ideally, you want to start in the far corners of your attic and work toward the exit. You can either take the roll of foil up and roll it out in the attic. You can use a broom handle or hang it from a pipe or something and create kind of a spool effect. Or you can pre-measure the pieces and just cut them outside and bring them up as needed. And that's where the poker we talked about earlier is going to come in handy. Just stab that foil and you can push it back all the way to the corner, push it back to the top plates of the wall. You don't want to push it down into the soffits. You don't want to block any airflow coming in from the soffits, but push it back as far as you can into the corners along the sides of the rafters. You may have an attic that's big and wide open with virtually no upright supports or ductwork in the attic. If you've got an attic like that, you can do something a little tricky to cover a lot of area fast. What you want to do is take two pieces, 4 feet wide, or maybe three pieces, roll them out in the driveway, so either get like an 8-foot or a 12-foot piece, take that roll of foil air conditioning tape, and just seam them together. Make yourself a big piece, maybe 8 feet by 20 feet long, roll it up like a rug, bring it into the attic, use that poker, just push it back into the corner of the area, push it along out to the outside, and you can cover a lot of area really fast. Eventually, you're going to get to a support coming up that you've got to cut the foil around. Now, you can just take your utility knife, cut one slit up, wrap it around, or if you want a little cleaner install for it to lay flat, what you can do is what I call it a double T-cut. You want to cut two slits about 5 inches wide and about 2 or 3 inches apart, and then take your knife, come from the bottom, come all the way up, then it'll wrap around, and that foil will just tuck down real close to the support. Nice, clean, easy install. It goes fast, and that's all you got to do to cut around the supports or the penetrations. They don't have to be perfect. A few gaps or cracks is perfectly fine. When it comes to overlapping the attic foil, I'm going to show you a little trick that's so simple and it works great. You don't need to tape the seams. In fact, it's actually pretty difficult to try to tape the whole seam while you're in the attic. So what you want to do is take the foil air conditioning tape, just little 2 or 3 inch pieces, create a little L shape, tape it on one side, and do that every 3 or 4 feet. Create little tabs, if you will. And then when you lay that piece on top, you can slide it back and forth. Remember, you only want to overlap an inch or two. Once you get that adjusted, then just take that stick, come through, just reach over, push that tab down, it'll stick to the other side. Then it's perfect. It's not going to slide apart, and you're not overlapping more than a couple of inches. That's all you have to do for the seams. If you've got a truss-built attic, I'd recommend using the 26-inch wide product. Normally, trusses are on 24 inches on center, so you can put a piece between each truss and it'll overlap just an inch or two, which is exactly what we want to do. And it's actually pretty simple. What you want to do is go into the attic, measure from the center of the attic out to the top plate of the wall. Say it's 14 feet. Once you get that measurement, go out in the garage and cut a bunch of pieces 14 feet long. That's going to go from the top plate of the wall to the center of the attic. Roll them up just like a bunch of posters, put them in a box, and carry them up into the attic. And then all you have to do is take your poker, grab each piece, and just push it all the way out to the top plate of the wall between the trusses. And then do the other side. In fact, you can actually put a nail on both ends, push to one side, take another piece, push to another side, go back one rafter, do one, do the other. That's all you have to do for a truss attic. And just like before, if you want to take a little piece of foil tape, you can put it on before, reach out, tack them together. That's all you have to do for a truss-built attic. One common question we get is, can I lay the attic foil directly on top of any plywood decking I have in the attic? And the answer is yes. Attic foil is super durable, tear-proof. Normal wear and tear and just walking on it is not going to damage the attic foil. You're going to get the main benefit in the summer. The heat coming off the roof, you're going to reflect it back. In the winter, you're going to reduce some of the radiant heat loss due to its emissivity. If you do this, I do one of two things. One, take a can of spray paint and outline where that plywood decking ends. Or two, take a piece of tape and do the same thing, outline it. The last thing you obviously want to do is step off the decking into your insulation. That's really all there is to it when installing attic foil radiant barrier directly over your attic insulation. Just remember the two big rules. One, cover as much area as possible. And two, only overlap the attic foil a couple of inches. Most homes, given a typical size and complexity, two people can complete a job in less than a day, maybe even just a few hours. We've had people do whole attics in 2 or 3 hours. And remember, it doesn't have to be perfect or pretty to work. If it's wrinkled or crooked, it works just fine. Next, I'm going to talk about the two most common questions we get. One, how does dust accumulation on the top of the attic foil affect its effectiveness? And second, questions and concerns about moisture being trapped underneath the attic foil. One of the common concerns we hear from customers is whether or not dust will accumulate on top of the attic foil and reduce its effectiveness. Now think about this for a second. How can dust get on top of the attic foil? First of all, it's got to be light enough that it comes into the attic, and then instantly it's got to be heavy enough that it falls on top of the attic foil. Most dust, either one, it never gets drawn into the attic, or two, it's going to come in and continue to go through the attic and out the top. I've been in a lot of attics 20, 30, 40 years old, and there's really not as much dust accumulation as people would think. Now, if you live next to a dirt road, yeah, you might have some more dust in your attic than a typical attic. But normally, it's really not a major concern. Let's say, though, that you are getting some dust accumulation on top of your attic foil. Now, attic foil is very reflective, and it's really pretty simple to tell. If you look down and it starts to look dull or not shiny, then obviously you're getting some dust accumulation. And most likely, this is going to be after 5 or 10 years. However, because of the double-sided attic foil, it works off two qualities, the reflectivity on this side and the emissivity quality on the other side. Now, I'm going to explain. Because normally you're just laying the foil on top of the attic insulation, you're going to have minimal contact and airspace between the foil and the top of the attic insulation. So even if you get a lot of dust on top, the bottom surface is working off a quality called emissivity. And if you're familiar with radiant barrier decking, there's products called TechShield, Solar Board, things like that. They're actually installed on the bottom of the roof deck so that foil faces the attic space. The way radiant barrier decking works is it works off the quality called emissivity. Basically, that roof gets hot, it doesn't allow that heat to radiate into the attic. So, even if you get a ton of dust, say it got so thick you couldn't even see the foil, basically it becomes radiant barrier decking. So it's still working off the emissivity quality. However, say for example, someday it gets to the point you actually have enough dust on it and you want to clean it out. Really, all you need, something like an air compressor or a leaf blower, you can blow it off. It's going to get back to probably 90% or better as far as reflectivity. But once again, dust accumulation is really not a typical concern in most attics. The other common question or concern we get when we talk about installing attic foil directly on top of the attic insulation is the potential or the concern for trapping moisture below the attic foil, which would cause the attic insulation to get wet and possibly mold or damage or something like that. Now, attic foil is perforated, so it's not a vapor barrier. Basically, if you made a bag out of attic foil and you put a wet sponge in, a few days later, it would be dry. The moisture would pass through the attic foil just like it was a brown paper bag. It's a pretty good air barrier, but it's not a moisture barrier. So in the attic, moisture is passing from wet to dry. In the winter, the moisture is inside the house. Normally it can pass directly through the sheetrock. If it can get through the sheetrock, it can easily pass through the attic insulation and through the foil. Basically, the bottleneck or the choke point is the sheetrock. However, moisture or condensation can only occur when one thing happens. That's when relatively warm, moist air comes in contact with a cold surface. Just like if you breathe on a window, you're going to get condensation. Or if you have a glass of iced tea, even though it may be 85 or 90 degrees out, it's relatively warm and moist. It's coming in contact with that cold surface. It's condensing into its liquid form or the water form. Now, in an attic, the attic is cold. Foil will be a cold surface. Now, the question is whether or not you have warm, moist air coming in contact with it. Normally, once again, the moisture will easily pass through. However, if you've got holes or penetrations that allow that warm, moist air to bypass the attic insulation, it can come up under and condense on the bottom of the attic foil. These things are like light fixtures, can lights, things like that. Basically, that warm, moist air can bypass and accumulate on the bottom of the attic foil. If this happens, you can potentially have some moisture accumulating on the bottom. So there's a couple of things you can do to keep this from happening. One, you want to seal up any penetrations in the ceiling. If you've got a can light, light fixtures, you obviously want to seal those up. You want to do that anytime for your home. You want it to be as airtight as possible. If you're not sure if they're airtight, then all you have to do is come through and just cut a hole in the foil above any holes in the ceiling. Say, for example, you got a can light, you're not sure if it's airtight, just cut a hole in the attic foil. That way, basically, you're giving it a path for that moisture just to go right past the attic foil. Finally, if you are concerned about moisture and you're not sure, what you can do is you can increase the permeability of the attic foil. And all you have to do, take your whole roll of attic foil, take a drill with either like an eighth or a quarter inch drill bit, and you're going to drill all the way through the roll into the center core. Maybe 30, 40, 50 holes per roll. Then when you unroll it, essentially it's going to be a big roll of Swiss cheese, and it's going to have little holes every now and then. That's going to greatly increase the permeability or the ability for moisture to pass through. You're still going to maintain a great air barrier, but you're making it more permeable for that moisture to pass through. If you have any questions or concerns, you can always call us at atticfoil.com. We'll help you with any questions you've got. We've got technical staff. We can help you either by phone call or email. If you enjoyed this video, please like this video by clicking the button below. Also, please share this video with your friends and neighbors so they can learn about radiant barrier, so they can help make their home more comfortable and energy efficient. Finally, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. You'll get notified every time we do a new video. And last, if you want to see some related videos, click on some of the buttons to the side. For any other information, visit atticfoil.com.